Alhamdulillah, we made it to Medina, just loading the coach. And we're going to go to the hotel, get everyone checked in. And yeah, we're here now, Alhamdulillah.
له ملك السماوات والأرض وإلى الله ترجع الأمور يولج الليل في النهار ويولج النهار في الليل وهو عليم بذات الصدور آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأنفقوا مما جعلكم مستخلفين فيه فالذين آمنوا منكم وأنفقوا لهم أجر كبير.
Brothers, Alhamdulillah, we have made it now to Medina. So there's some things that I want to inform you now that we have made it to Medina. So a person now needs to be aware in terms of his dealings with other brothers, in terms of joking, in terms of mocking. These are all sins. If a person, especially, you know, something you may consider light, as the Prophet ﷺ informed us, a person may say a statement which comes easy from the mouth, but is something great in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so because of this statement that he didn't give consent to, Allah will put this person into the hellfire just for a statement that he just said, and it didn't even mean anything to him, but in the sight of Allah it meant something great. And vice versa as well, a person could say something that he didn't even give consent to, but it could be the means for him to enter Jannah. So brother, just be aware in terms of your dealings with amongst each other, amongst the people as well.
Cool. With that said, inshallah ta'ala, let's just go through some information about Medina. Okay, Medina is the second most sacred city in Islam. The first most sacred city is Mecca. Mecca tul Mukarrama. This is Medina tul Munawwara. The city of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What makes it so special? How did it become special? What is the historical situation of the city? The Prophet used to be from Mecca. And when he was in Mecca, he was driven out of his land. The people tried to kill him. Why? Because he wanted to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They used to torture him. He used to go to the Kaaba and pray. He would make sajda. And as he's making sajda, they would come and take a cloth, wrap it around his neck and choke him while he's trying to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Everyone else, do you want to come in for a second, inshallah? Is it all seven?
Yeah, it's all double.
All right, guys, come in, inshallah. Basically, the reason there was a delay is because all of you guys, we upgraded you to the biggest suite here. Inshallah, yeah. So we want to send the youngers off first, so they don't take it too deep. But all of you guys, mashallah, you got the big boy suites. So sorry about the wait.
No problem. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So inshallah ta'ala, we're about to go out for the first day with our group, inshallah. See you guys soon.
وَمَا لَكُمْ لَا تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولُ يَدْعُوكُمْ لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ وَقَدْ أَخَذَ مِيثَاقَكُمْ إِن كُنتُم مُّؤْمِنِينَ هُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُمْ لَرَءُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ وَمَا لَكُمْ ألا تنفقوا في سبيل الله ولله ميراث السماوات والأرض لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح وقاتل أولئك أعظم درجة من الذين أنفقوا من بعد وقاتلوا وكلا وعد الله الحسنى والله بما تعملون خبير.
What have you not seen about the masjid so far?
5 star.
Seven star. Seven star. So the masjid is 5 star, just like the hotel, yeah? SubhanAllah.
Yeah, obviously.
The masjid is 100 stars. 100 stars, yeah? What do you think, Akhi? Was it good, yeah?
Yeah. Times 100,000 for each prayer. SubhanAllah.
And then there's even extra things for specific circumstances and situations. Good. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention to you the specific things from this book that we're going to focus on in this trip. Because we're not going to focus on all of the du'as mentioned here. The reward is just out as well. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَبَقَ الْمُفَرِّدُونَ. He said, the mufarridun, they're beating everyone. He got ahead of the race. Another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, a man will come on the day of judgment, and his sins will be weighed up. And his sins, the scrolls will be so high, they're like skyscrapers. They're massive. He's done all and every single type of sin that you could think of. This guy might have murdered, he might have fornicated, he might have disrespected his parents, filthy on his tongue, might have done all sorts of stupidity. His sins are so high.
Assalamu alaikum. Brothers and sisters, as you guys may be aware, we do Umrah trips where we take brothers and we also take sisters. Those who are not practicing, those who are on the streets, those who are on the verge of losing their iman, some of them. And we take them on this Umrah trip and it functions as a spiritual rehabilitation and reformation for them. We're taking people that have spent over 10 years in jail. We're taking people who were involved in drugs, usage of drugs, selling drugs, criminal activity. But alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, these people, they change now. They change it and they do a 180. And not only that, some of them went on to study their religion, seek knowledge. And some of them are now starting to work towards, you know, after a while, starting to become positive figures in their community and getting other people off the streets and getting them involved in deed and knowledge and da'wah. So alhamdulillah, it's actually quite a holistic experience. So I wanted to basically say two things to you guys. Number one, if you'd like to accompany us, then know that we've got another trip, inshallah ta'ala, in November for the brothers. And 20 spaces already gone. 20 spaces already gone. There's about 20 plus just left. So now go to the contact number below. It's a WhatsApp number. If you're from a different country, you can join us. From the UK, you can call us. Inshallah, just message us right now, inshallah ta'ala. Okay? The second thing is, we take brothers. We take brothers. And also sometimes we take sisters, of course, with their mahram, who really need this trip. They are like the people that I just mentioned a second ago, but they can't afford it because either their money is haram or they're just broke, they don't have the money, but they need this trip for their iman. Listen, it could be that these people, if you help send them, you help change their life, then you get the reward of sending them to Umrah and even the good that they do after, inshallah ta'ala. So if you could please donate at the link below generously so people like that can have an opportunity to change their life and have a second chance at life, inshallah ta'ala, we'll be truly grateful. I know they definitely would. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, will reward you in abundance. So please, if you want to come, hit the link below, inshallah ta'ala. And if you want to donate, also hit the link below, inshallah ta'ala. Sorry, if you want to come, ring the number below, inshallah ta'ala. And if you'd like to donate, hit the link below, inshallah ta'ala. Barakallahu feek. Salamu alaykum.